The position is simple. We followed due process. The Mostert government followed due process, set up a panel of inquiry composed of eminent jurists and responsible citizens of the state. So I don't see what anybody just has to complain. I've heard a lawyer talk about antecedent of the government of Imo State. Unless the antecedent he's talking about is an antecedent referable to Rogers. Because for his 8 years in office, he never obeyed one court order. So if that is the antecedent he's referring to, not to this administration. This administration is a law-abiding one.
Seems to be implying that there's a witch hunt. Yes.
Well, witch hunt implies that something is being done surreptitiously. Yeah. Something is being done in the dark. I don't see what the panel sat in the open, received memoranda from members of the public, had evidence. So if he chose to boycott it, how can he call that boycott? What did you call it? Witch hunt. And by the way, looking at the gamut of people he sued, some of the panels don't concern him. You may want to know, what is the business of the governor with, or the former governor, with a panel probing local government administration? Should that bother him? If the local government administration ran or was run the way the law stipulated it should be run. So that gives you an idea that he has something to hide.
He has also, his fear is that his properties are currently being marked for demolition.
Well, unfortunately, those properties are now in most government properties. So let him contest that. The proper thing to do is, Imo State now says, these properties now belong to us. Go to court and challenge it. Go to court and say, no, I own this property, not you. That's the way it should be done.
Okay.
This is Aduri, I'm a senior advocate.
I'm the lad that handled the forfeiture of properties case in Owerri. All I want to say is that the properties forfeited were government properties, government university. Somebody wakes up, himself, his wife, and all his children became the owners of that university, built with public funds. Properties acquired with government money, they were established. Now, lands, both of the poor man and the mighty man. Demolitions were done without notice, without court order, without compensation. Many people had their businesses ruined during that administration. The panels were set up not by the incumbent governor, but by Right Honorable Emeka Ihedioha. When he became governor of Imo State, May 29, 2019. So he set up all these panels, investigate financial transactions during his tenure, investigate contracts, investigate appointments and promotions, because civil service was bastardized, and the use of consultants brought in to take over statutory functions of public servants. Investigate administration of lands, because the master plan was completely destroyed. Buildings were erected where they were not supposed to be erected. Lands belonging to government, Maestro Record quarters, Imo Broadcasting Corporation quarters, Imo State University staff quarters, Alvan quarters, former secretariats both at Okigwe Road and Olu Road, even land reserved for government house, permanent site of government house. Everything was converted to his own and his family. So the panel finished its work, submitted the reports before they came to court. They were already writing reports. Now they finished their reports, submitted. A wiper was issued August 2020. Now, nobody has gone to court challenging the validity of that white paper. White paper have been, it signifies acceptance. Government has accepted the recommendations, gazetted it, and acquired the character of law. So Our going to court was to show that what we are doing is procedural, legally in order. The court has given judgment in the matter, final judgment. Those properties he took like an emperor have now been recovered by the government. The court sanctioned it and said it's okay. This suit is even a surplusage, because once you issue that white paper, anybody affected thereby ought to have gone to court.
Then why is his counsel filing?
He is trying to deceive the court. He has even appeared against that judgment, brought an application for injunction there, and we are waiting for him. He kept, now, what race is he trying to preserve here? His course of action is that we reported to EFCC and we also set up panels. That is double jeopardy. Double jeopardy applies where you prosecute somebody in a criminal court. Either you acquit him or discharge him. And you want to try him again, you can say no, don't try him a second time, it's double jeopardy. Now, the police has had a discretion to investigate or prosecute or not to. And that does not take away the powers of the governor to set up a panel of inquiry over anything he wants to. And they concede that in their process. They say, yes, we agree, that is the law. But then why are they here? They are just trying to bring politics, waste the time of the court, create tension all over the place. And the more resources they acquired, they are now wasting it anyhow. Have you seen a governor, former governor, saying, I am richer than the whole state? Have you heard that before, except in Imo State? Are people not surprised that these things are happening? So what we are trying to do is to ensure that there is a standard for good governance in Imo State, as it is in Anambra and other places. That is our concern. It's here wasting time.
Thank you very much.